oxygen.
No idea what to do that, but hey.
Run.
I can see it, Sam. Can you see it?
No, I'm looking the wrong way.
It's... I can't explain it. I can feel it.
Red dot, weird half ladder, that thingy. Red dot, half ladder, weird thingy. Right. Periscope again, aren't we? Well, red dot. Triangle. Double arrow. Disco ball. Red dot. Triangle. Double arrow. And whatever that mental thing was. I'm assuming we're talking. Weird pong thingy, triangle, red dot, a weird pong thingy, and triangle. Should be pyramid, not triangle. Neptune. Ah, still Saturn.
Why or how you were doing this. If you are doing this, but I need you to help me, Sam. I need to know what is going on. I need the crew.
We both need to know what's going on.
Is back, but the hatch to Universal is still offline. I need you to find out what the problem is. Sam, give me a systems diagnostic.
Module EAS-1 is pressurized.
But the problem must be somewhere else then.
What about UNO-1?
Module UN-1 hull contact points to EAS-3 are unresponsive.
This sounds bad.
Oh, okay, we're done.
Okay, so the power is fine, but the hull connection points are misaligned. That we can fix. I can't get them open from here, but you should be able to reclamp the contact points from outside. Looks like you're going on your first spacewalk, Sam. Before you go outside, though, we need to update your sphere firmware to allow for exterior use. To upgrade, you'll have to scan the barcodes in EAS 11. Once you're fully updated, we'll get you outside. I'm granting you EVA permission now. The internal airlock hatch is now open.
What do I need to scan? I need to scan barcodes. No. Oh, what's that? yeah, cool. Combine files and memory core. Right, move the cursor, exit zoom in. Wow, look how much I've lost. Clover type thing. What am I meant to do? Search for fragments. Oh, okay, so you use these ones. Okay. And my flashlight.
Great, that's you all set up. Okay, get those module clamps fixed, Sam.
Woo, let's go to space. That's where we want to be, wasn't it? So yeah, we want to close that one. So depressurize. Open the external hatch.
The control panel where you can rearrange the clamps is on the outer hull of EAS-3. We could maybe check out a US-12 while we're out here.
Now that is cool. Hey, Saturn. Wow. That's 11. That's 9. So, yeah, we're going to say that's 2.
Straight down, Sam. The controls are at the bottom of the EAS arm.
Yeah, you talk like
getting
I know.
Closer. Look for the controls on EAS-3.
Where's EAS-3? Completely lost already. It's ES2. Is this No, that's the AS1. Okay, so this should be 3. Right, and what clamps? Those hull contacts look alright. So I'm assuming. God, it controls like a bit awkwardly, but those are the only things I can see that are hull. Oh, you're the hull contact. Okay. Yeah, no, you're fine. You're fine. We're all fine. I'm confused. What am I missing?
What would you like me to do?
Sam, get those clamps disengaged. I'll be watching your feed.
Clamps? Right, let's zoom out. Oh, sugar. I completely lost myself. Okay. How? Sure how. Oh. I searched that earlier, I'm pretty sure. Oh, wait. Actually read the instructions. Right, hold X. Hold triangle. Release triangle. Release X.
That's it. Whoa. The hull connection points are reading true. that's working. Yeah, it's working. It's gonna take a few minutes while the module connection runs its pressure checks. Sam, while you're out there, take a closer look at the damage you detected earlier on the station exterior. What can you see?
That was... I can't remember where that was. Right. I need to try and get my bearings. I feel like that's one of the hardest things. Oh?
Damage to AS4 exterior is superficial.
Okay, looks like we got that fire before it got out of hand.
Wasn't there, was it that thing?
What would you like me to do, Emma?
Sam, that damage, any ideas?
Okay, so that's not the thing that was damaged. This was, wasn't it? No. I can't remember what was damaged last time. Well, you guys look damaged.
The solar arrays are showing evidence of torsion and stress.
Whatever this station has gone through, the arrays had no chance. Take a closer look at the China and Russian arms. The damage to the top of them looked pretty severe.
Isn't that one of these? What? I thought I was meant to... That looks pretty severe to me. Alright, we'll try this thing.
An unknown material is present at hull fracture points.
That looks like what I found in EAS-4. What the hell is it?
How is that noise?
Bring the sphere back inside and meet me in EAS-3. Let's get this hatch open. I hope to God the others are okay.
Low power level. Great. Right, we'll close that. Repressurize. Sounds like my alarm clock for mornings and will open the hatch.